Hi, buddy.
Dad's talking about doing your feet. You guys ain't going to be in the video today. Hey, horse people. I'm going to talk about this tools that this Evo Hoof Care. Hell, I don't know the damn name. www.evolutionaryhoofcare. No, wait a minute. What is it? www.evolutionaryhoofcare.com. Okay, here's a little symbol. I wrote the lady, she's a nice lady. I said, hey, I'm getting a lot of questions about your hoof tool. And I said, I do my own feet, but if you want to send me one, I'll use it and review it. And I told her I'd send it back because I'm not trying to. I said, I'll send it back when I'm done. She goes, don't worry about it. So she sent me some stuff. So I'm just going to go over what she sent me and explain a couple things. And then I'll actually do a part two where I got the horses and I'm going to work it. So this is their, what's it called? Radius Rasp Pro. Okay, it's got a nice curve there. This slides out if you put a piece of wood right here. If I was going to take this out so I could move it, I had a block of wood or a piece of wood, I would just set this on here like so. And they have nice videos. When you go to their website, if you go to their videos, they have a guy working with all these. But I've never used them. And I usually just work with a rasp, so I'm like, eh, what the hell. If she wants to send me one, I'll try it. See if it works. See if it's better. So, the good thing about this is right the way the rasp is, this is the front, so I'm pushing forward with my palm, but I'm actually kind of rolling around a hoof. And I describe it a lot when, if women do their fingernails, how they take the little raspy thing, I forgot what they call it, I don't know, the little filey thing that women use. And you'll see them, they'll roll this way, and they'll go up and down, and they'll take corners off, and they'll go back and forth. So this is the same thing you're doing with this to a horse's hoof. And I'm just rolling the edge to make it stronger. And there was a guy who sent me an email, and I can't, you know, I've only got like 1,000 something emails saved in my email file, but somewhere it's in there that he explained to me why rounding, I thought he used the term fulcrum, but I'm not sure, but he explained it in a scientific formula: by curving the edge, you make the hole stronger. So this little tool right here, when I'm using it, I'm going to go around the hoof and make it just like I would do with a regular rasp, if this is a rounded rasp, and I'm just going to push and back, you know, going around it and make it smooth and circle. Looks like a really well made, it's a good heavy piece of plastic. This slides in there nice and tight. They sell replaceable blades. Like I said, if you go to their website, you can watch other videos. So this is all I expected her to send me, because it's the only thing I ask about. She sent me a box of all kind of things, so I'm going to show you what she sent me. So this one has a rasp, and it's called the Radius Rasp Pro. This is called the Radius Wrap Magnet Inside. Oh, there is a magnet inside. Hey, I just saw it. They didn't do it. There's a little magnet in here so I can clip this to things. Hey, that's pretty cool. It's not strong enough to click to that. Hey, that's pretty slick. So it's got a magnet inside. So this one has a little thin piece of metal. This one is like a regular rasp. And they show on their website on how to use them. I think you use 1, 2, and then you finish with a sander. This one is more coarse. This one makes it smoother or something. I'm not sure. I'll figure it out when I do it, because we'll do it together when I get my horses out here. And I'm going to roll it around and see which one does that. And I'm going to use a regular rasp. And I'll just test it out and see if I like it, if I think it's easier, if I think it's something that I would buy. Maybe I'll buy a couple and do a giveaway. So these are pretty cool. And I didn't even know about the magnet. Now they're really cool. Wow. It sticks to my head. Look. All right. So, then the other thing she sent me, which I didn't even know they made, which is pretty cool, it's called the Bar and Sole Rasp. So this is a little hoof pick. If you pull off the little plastic thing, that's a little hoof pick. So if I gotta pick the hoof, I can use this. But it also gives me a thumb support or to pull. So basically it's a little rounded curved rasp, and it has this edge is sharper and this one is longer. And I can either pull or push on the sole, so when I have the hoof turned upside down, I can go around a frog and get the bars. I can actually smooth out the sole and make the sole nice and smooth. I'm really looking forward to using this. This is just seems like a great idea. Now the other ones, the blades are changeable. I don't think this is changeable, but she shows how you can rasp it if you go to the site, or he does. But the person I'm dealing with, I think, is Linda. So she was, that's why I'm saying she. So anyway, this is kind of cool because I can push, I can turn it around, and I can pull. I can use two hands if the hoof is really hard or long, and I get more leverage. So if you're a little weaker, I'm pulling with this hand and I'm pushing with this hand, but doing it together will give me a nice rasping on that hoof and sole and get that bar down. So this is pretty cool. I was pretty excited when I opened it up. I go, wow, this sucker's cool. So I'm looking forward to using this. Then she sent me this sucker. And I got it and I was like, what the hell is this? Because I had never seen it. I didn't watch any video. So I'm like, all right, well, maybe you stick your hand in here and you do this. Or then I watched the video and you hold it and basically you use this as a sander and you go around the hoof. And I can switch hands, I can use two hands, I can pull it, I can do the radial rasp like I do with a rasp now, except it's sandpaper. It's not real flexible. This is a thing to tighten and loosen it. I don't think she sent me a wrench for this. It says it comes with a wrench, but that's okay, I got a wrench. So you just put a wrench on here and you can move this and it tightens it so you can take this off and spin it. So this is pretty cool, and this comes with, hey, you know what? I think she did send a wrench. I'm sorry, I was talking smack about her. This is probably a wrench. I just saw this piece of paper in there. Yeah, hey, it is a wrench. So basically you just put this on here and then you twist it to either tighten it or loosen it, and then you can change the blade. So this is a little bit coarser piece of sandpaper, like a belt sander, and this one's a little finer. So I mean, all these are pretty cool. I'm looking forward to this one too, because this looks like I could really just like grab the hoof and do a quick sanding. If I see a little nick or something, I can just carry this out here without getting on my tools, pick the hoof up and go. And I can do it from the bottom or I can do it from the top. So if the hoof is like this, I can sand around and take a little chip off real quick. And if I want to turn it upside down, I can just work for the bottom, even it out, and then roll the edge a little bit. So pretty cool idea, pretty cool tools. Again, they're pretty cool. I haven't used them yet, but I mean, they look like the concept, they're gonna be pretty cool. So I'm really partial to this one. I ain't even used it yet and I fell in love with it. I go, how stinking cool is this, man? I'll be able to get those, because those bars are hard to get with. You're almost using that little knife and you gotta push on one side with the knife and pull. This, I feel like I'm gonna have a lot more leverage. I can get two hands and really get in there. And it shows on there, you can just roll it and kind of rasp it like this with a roll, which really gives you a lot stronger strength when you're using this on the hoof versus that hoof knife, to where you gotta use your thumb and you're pulling and you gotta keep it sharp. This looks like a cool idea. I can't wait to use this. So anyway, here's our little brochure. Evolutionary Hoof Care. You can go to their website, evolutionaryhoofcare.com. It's got little pictures of it and all that, but I don't know how many people, there's a bunch of people using this that watch me, or there's a bunch of people that want to use it and they kind of wanted me to cover it, because I had a whole bunch of questions on this. Man, would you get one and try it, and would you tell if it's any good? And I'm like, all right, I'll figure I'll shoot them an email. I think that's the first, other than a halter, that's the first thing I ever got free, so that's kind of cool. But it was nice of them to send it, and but I didn't promise that I'd say good things, and if I don't like it, She may write me back and go, send it back. You gave us a bad... I mean, they look pretty cool. So I'm going to give you an honest review on what I think and what I found. And I might give Mr. T's opinion on how he's doing and what he thinks of it. And Mr. T will be like, I don't need no damn hoof care. Give me some mountains to run and my hoofs will be fine. Buddy, he don't care. Remember, Buddy's hoofs are a little softer. So I'm not going to have to use it as hard on Buddy's. But Mr. T's is a little tougher, which I'm really looking forward to working out on the bars and his sole. So anyway, that's Evolutionary Hoof Care. That's their little care package they sent me to try out. I'm going to try it out and let you guys know what I think. And we'll make that part 2.